So today, we'll use the carousel component to work on the hero. First, let's create a new component. So open your code editor, open components, and here you can create a new file, hero.js. We'll create a functional component, so add export default function and the component name. I will add app hero. In return, let's add a div tag with the text hero. We'll then import this component under app.js. So on top, import app hero. Then at the bottom, after the header tag, add a main tag. Inside main, add the app hero element. Let's check the preview. And currently, the hero component is hiding under the header. So if you remove position fixed, you can see the hero component over here. Now let's add the carousel component. So open React Bootstrap, click components, and click carousel. Copy the import of carousel and add them under hero.js. Then copy this carousel element. You can remove this div tag and instead add a section. You can use the ID home and a class hero block. Inside this section, you can paste the carousel element. Pick the preview, and we can see the carousel is working. Now, instead of adding the static content, let's add the dynamic one. So on top, I will just paste the hero data. It has got properties like ID, image, title, description, and link. Now let's use map function to get this hero data. So out of three carousel items, let's remove two of them. And after the carousel element, let's add the map function. So you can add hero data dot map. We can then access hero. Then inside this return, let's add the carousel item. To access the image, we can now use hero.image. In the alt, we can use slide plus hero.id so that it would be slide 1, slide 2, and so on. For the title, we can use hero.title. For description, you can use hero.description. Then for the button, let's use the anchor tag. Text of the button is learn more. We'll add a class btn and btn primary. For href, we will use hero.link. Finally, in this carousel item, let's add the key attribute and set them to hero.id. check the preview, and we can see the carousel is working. The only thing that is missing now is the icon. So we will use the developer tool. We can then copy this icon and paste them over here. Check the preview again, and this time it is looking exactly the same as in the design. Great. This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.